recteq lifestyle. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Do, do, do. Recteq lifestyle.
What's up, recteq family? Watch this whole video and see if you can spot Rex. If you do, put in the comment section the timestamp that you see him and your favorite dish of the day, and you may win something.
Gloves clean. Do you want to put that board right here? Do, do, do. Cornbread and fried chicken, ribs and delicious. Live your life the way you like, recteq lifestyle.
Do, do, do.
Do, do, do. Man, it is fantastically awesome outside.
It
I don't think there's
good.
A cloud in the sky.
Feels good.
I'm about to turn the fans up because we've been running around a little bit getting this going.
Yeah.
It's probably not as hot back here as it up in Memphis.
Yeah.
So I'll give a huge shout out to Jody and the gang. You got Matt Lane up there. You got co-founders Ray Carnes, Ron Cundy. You got I guess he's not really an intern anymore since he kind of graduated.
That's right.
But intern extraordinaire Colton Carnes, Miss Beth Carnes, all up in Memphis. Did you see a whole hog porchetta they did?
That looked awesome.
Okay. You guys have got to check out the Shed Barbecue and Jody Flanagan on Instagram because he put pictures up of this whole hog porchetta.
Yeah,
they took this pig. It was like deboned. It was stuffed with boudin and all sorts of witchcraft. It looked amazing. But they stuffed that bad boy on the BFG 20 RT2500. That skin on point.
Looked great. It really did. You could almost taste it through the video.
It was crazy. So again, this Funday Friday we're going to do for you guys is going to be competition ribs.
That's right.
So we're going to show you how to break down some spare ribs into St. Louis cut. We're also going to show you baby backs because we have a lot of questions
That's
about
right.
that too. But typically
right.
your competition ribs will be your St. Louis cut. So this is the fourth installment of our
That's
competition
right.
May series.
That's right.
Next week,
yep.
we'll be on location in Augusta, Georgia at Lake Olmsted Stadium.
That's right.
We'll be crushing banjo BBQ. We're getting that banjo.
We're going for it.
It's gonna happen. So I'm excited.
I'm super excited.
But let's get right into this, right? So I've got the Bull RT700 and the Stampede RT590 preheated behind me to 250 degrees. The only pellet I burn is the Ultimate Blend Red Oak, White Oak, and Hickory. If you want to win competitions, you get that pellet. Hands down, best pellet ever.
That's the way to go, for sure.
So this here is going to be a full spare rib, right? And you can go to a store and you can find St. Louis cut ribs. But again, we're going to use a spare rib and show you how to break it down. And there are other competitions out there that use baby backs.
Yes, that's right.
But for KCBS and stuff. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to flip this over.
Chef, did you just get these from the supermarket, or are these from a special place? Or
well, the ones on the grill are some special ribs.
Okay.
So one of the ribs we're using at Memphis and May with the Shed, Prairie Farms. It's an organic pork. We got a couple of those racks up
nice.
Here. But I figured we go to Sam's Club, we break this down. So this piece here is going to be your skirt, and you want to go about three bones back. Okay, so right here. This is actually this where you see the end of that joint. That's actually going to be the longest bone in your rack.
That's right.
So what you want to do is just kind of mark that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my knife and I'm going to cut right across to make my beautiful rack of ribs. Okay, so since I am right-handed, I'm going to turn this around. But again, I'm going to cut here and keep it as square as possible all the way across. And again, nice sharp knife. Makes life really easy. And you want to keep, again, a nice square cut. Just like that.
Perfect.
That's what I'm saying. Now, this is not garbage.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, you're going to tell these people what to do with this,
You can
right?
smoke this off, you can chop it up, you can pull out some of the cartilage, you can add that to some spaghetti sauce.
Add
that
it to baked beans.
Perfect. No doubt. So again, if we look now, that rack of ribs is nicely square. I'm going to take the skirt off because we're not going to eat it on the racks, but I'm just going to get in here with a knife and just kind of trim it back. And it's all about keeping things uniform. And I'm also going to go probably two rib bones back, so one, two, and I'm just going to square this off right here. Okay? So super simple. You see how nice and square that is? We'll kind of clean this up a little bit because it's got to be pretty.
That's right.
Okay? So this is nice and looking pretty good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here, I'm going to pull this membrane off the back. John, how do you pull your membrane?
I usually just with a paper towel, I start on one edge and then it usually just comes right on up for me.
So for me, I'll just take my thumb underneath and just kind of make a gap, just like that. And I'll just pull it off. Sometimes it comes off in one fell swoop. Sometimes you got to work at it a little bit. This one's cooperating pretty good.
Yeah, see, that's why I like the paper towel too, because it helps you give it a little better grip.
You got to do a grip. Mm-hmm. I used to actually take a fork, put a fork under here, and then twist it back. But if you're a textured tip gloves, makes life really easy.
Yeah.
Best gloves ever. You can pick this up at recteqgrills.com. $9.98 a box. They come in barbecue mediums.
That's right.
And extra
large. That's right for those guys with, you know, them big hands.
Yep. So what I'll do is a little more cleanup on here. And again, these bottom ribs here will be for you and I to taste.
Okay.
And we're going to live dangerously. We're really only going to cook one rack. So we'll see if we can get a good barbecue box out of that.
I love it.
And all this other side here, I'll just take a knife. I'll kind of clean some of this up because it's kind of yucky. But
how far do you go as far as cleaning it, though? Do you like to get in there, or how do you?
Well, since this is going to be kind of our flavor rib, we're not really going to eat that one. If there's big pockets in here, I'll actually just lift that rack up and just kind of trim it off a little bit. And that way, you know, we get nice clean ribs. And I'm a scruncher when it comes to putting ribs in the grill. So after we season them, I'm actually going to kind of scrunch them together a little bit.
And I've heard this method before.
You got to scrunch, man. If you've never scrunched before,
I wasn't a scruncher. Yeah.
Well, maybe you'll be a scruncher this time.
I'm telling you.
All right, so I've got our injection here. And there's kind of two schools of thought when it comes to ribs. Some inject and some don't. I just do a little bit of injection because I want that rib to be nice and moist on the middle.
Definitely.
And the injection we're using today is the Butcher's Barbecue Pit Pork. So if you guys want to check out all of those awesome rubs, injections that all of those top-level barbecue teams are using, check out our friends at AtlantaBBQStore.com. Right now, for the entire month of May, it's 10% off.
What?
So get on there, check out some stuff. And if you're unsure what to buy, you can go back for the last couple Funday Fridays, and you'll see our recommendations.
Right.
But pick up the phone, shoot him an email.
Yeah.
Brian Jarvis and his wife, can't think of her name right now. It's going to come to me in a little bit. Ellen. Ellen Jarvis. Sorry, you remember that one. We'll give you some recommendations of some really cool stuff. So
super helpful.
Again, they stock everything we're using with today, and we'll get into the rubs here in a little bit. But I'm going to go ahead and inject into these ribs just a hair. And
so do you look for any in these ribs specifically, what flavor profile were you looking for in the injection?
So this is going to give me a little bit of a salty umami. It's also got a little bit of a sweetness to it.
Right.
But you want to, competition ribs are not my favorite. I'm not going to lie. They're kind of like icky sweet.
Right.
But, you know, it is what
that's
it is.
That's what wins, right?
Yep. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stand that rack up, and I'm going to inject just a small dose of that injection right in between the bone. And as I pull out, just give a little squeeze. And I'm a huge fan of this spit jack injector. It puts the injection where I need it and not where I don't. Keeps things nice and easy. And I like the fact that I can set the dose so that I don't over or under inject. And it's all about consistency here, guys.
Where did you get that injector, Chef?
You can pick this up on Amazon.com. I'm not sure if it's at Atlanta BBQ store or not.
I'm sure they have something comparable though, right?
Oh, I'm sure they can hook you up. Yeah. I mean, this is kind of overkill, but I mean,
you're overkill, Chef. That's how you do things.
Grill big or go home, right?
That's right. That's right.
Now, normally we would rub these down with mustard and whatnot, but we're not going to do that today. You want to grab a rack of baby backs, and we'll show them a quick difference while you got it up here.
For
and
sure.
If any extra injection, just kind of squeeze out. That's going to be your binder. And that's it. We maybe put 2 ounces of injection in there. And you'll notice these bones here are nice and flat, okay? Your baby backs are going to have a curve to them. So if you look at kind of my bones and John's bones here, you see how that rack has some curvature to it? These are going to be flat. That's the biggest difference. St. Louis ribs will be a little bit more meaty, have a little bit more fat to them, whereas your baby backs will be a little bit more lean. So we're going to go ahead and get these seasoned up. We're going to use two special rubs here. This is going to be a Smokin' Guns Hot. Again, this is available at LantaBBQStore.com. It's got a little bit of a kick to it. And then we're also going to use another rub called Cimarron Docks, and this is going to be a sweet rub. The favorite rub for us, if I'm doing backyard ribs like these baby backs, I'm going Rossarooski's.
Yeah. Yeah, he knows his rub.
I mean, it's fantastic. And I'll normally let that sit for about 5 minutes, let it sweat out, but, I mean, we're living the recteq lifestyle. Again, a little Smokin' Guns Hot over the top, and a dab of do you with this stuff.
So mustard isn't necessary for a binder. You could just use whatever you'd like.
We're using injection. You can use olive oil. Now that mustard cooks off. I hate yellow mustard.
Do you hate it, Chef?
Man, I mean, I hate to use that word, hate.
Yeah, for real. That's a strong
word.
I'll
say despise.
Okay, all right.
You put mustard on a hot dog or a hamburger, we're not friends.
Oh my gosh.
I
heard it here first.
So normally I'll let this sweat out. And that's going on the grill.
Looks great.
But today was a pretty cool day.
Right.
So my daughter graduated kindergarten today.
All right. Check it out. Congratulations.
Look at how cute she is right there. Right. So she's swimming in the pool behind us. We had to celebrate at Waffle House.
Yeah.
And when I was ready to leave Waffle House at like, I don't know, 10:30, guy was like, hey, what are you cooking today? We're doing competition ribs. So if you guys are watching Waffle House,
shout out.
Whiskey Road,
there you go.
And Aiken, breakfast was amazing.
There you go. Good
so job, we'll go ahead Waffle. And we'll get these on the grill just like that. Super simple. Come on, country, let's get in here close.
Looking great.
And I'm a scruncher, so again, give it a little squeeze together and watch that meat kind of plump up. That's what you want. And again, if you guys are looking for our injections and seasonings, these are what they look like. Give a shout out to AtlantaBBQStore.com. You can reach out to them on Facebook. They are awesome, awesome people. But we will be back live at 12 o'clock.
Awesome.
Chef John and I, we're going to get some baby backs on.
Because right.
We got to feed people around here.
We definitely do.
So if you guys want to see some behind-the-scenes stuff, let's maybe let's jump on one of our Facebook pages.
But
you got to follow us both to see how we prep these ribs.
Totally.
We can't go on Twitter because Rex and Jordan aren't here.
That's right.
If you guys want to see some behind-the-scenes stuff, we'll get some baby backs prepped.
For sure.
Maybe we'll go rogue on both pages.
I'm telling you.
Dueling Facebook.
Share and like all this stuff if you know somebody who likes baby back ribs, and everybody does.
Fantastic.
So, yeah.
So if you guys want to see all of our secrets for competition ribs, make sure you join us again at 12 o'clock. We'll show you the next step in the process.
All right.
We'll see you guys at the recteq. Come on, country. Check these out. That rib went on at about 8:30. This one went on at 10 o'clock. We'll wrap that one up on camera. We'll show you the secrets there. Good stuff. We got that ultimate blend pellet back here, red oak, white oak, and hickory. There's nothing better than that guy right there. Look at all this smoke out of this bowl, buddy. Best pellet grill around.
Greg's a mime.
Are you miming it, or are you just... There you go. Barbecue mime.
What's up, recteq family? You gotta be a barbecue mime. Why not?
I like it.
Hey, if you want a really cool pair of white gloves like this,
yes,
just enter some barbecue competitions.
That's it.
Because you put your recteq nitrile gloves on the top, it keeps your hands nice and clean. And most importantly, if you have pantry paws, we work in restaurants.
Yes.
I can't feel my hands.
Yep.
I can go in and out of an oven.
Yep.
It don't matter.
It's true.
But if you don't work in a restaurant, stuff's hot.
It's real hot.
You got pantry paws. Get some linen gloves under your nitrile gloves.
Be good to go.
No muss, no fuss. Makes it easy.
Really good.
But hey, guys, this week of Funday Friday is all about competition ribs.
That's it.
It is kind of the last installment of our competition series.
That's right.
Only to be blown up next week at Banjo-BQ.
That's it.
But if you guys want to make sure you follow all of our stuff, make sure you subscribe on YouTube.
That's right.
This entire episode will be loaded up on YouTube. If you watch it in its entirety and you kind of listen, we kind of tell you what you got to do, you might win something.
I'm just saying.
You might win something.
It's happened before.
But the winner last week, we did pork butts.
That's right.
It was awesome. We were back at the warehouse. Then we went to Waynesboro, Georgia for Boss Hog.
That's right.
But I want to give a congratulations to Lester Palmer with
time
of 25 minutes and 5 seconds.
Good job. Good job.
Lester, if you want to... If you want to claim your prize of unspeakable value, make sure you email Madeline, M-A-D-E-L-I-N-E at recteqgrills.com. We're jumping in pools around here because it's graduation.
Mm-hmm.
This pretty girl graduated. She graduated kindergarten today. Like, I mean, in a couple of years, it's going to be college.
I'm telling you, you're getting old, Chef.
Hey,
you're getting old.
You had a birthday the other day.
I know.
So
I turned 35 again.
That's messed up. All right, Country, let's come over to the Bull Archie 700. We'll show what we got going on. Again, I put these on before graduation because that's how you live the recteq lifestyle. You put your meat on, you go do what's important, and you don't worry about it. Why? Because that Y-Pellet Wi-Fi controller has your back. It doesn't deviate. This 40-pound hopper burns an ultimate blend pellet. You can cook for 40 hours at around 300 degrees. It's got your back. All right, so this rack we put on about a half an hour ago, it's just starting to sweat. This rack we put on about 2 hours and 20 minutes ago. I don't care what the internal temperature is. Don't care. It's got great color. That's what I'm looking for right there. John, can you do me a favor and close that one for me?
Yeah.
So people say, well, what temp? Competition? We don't care. Not right now. All right? It's all about that beautiful mahogany color. And if you notice some of these black spots that come up, it's actually like a blood vessel that is kind of busted in there. And what you do is just take a knife, and you can actually scrape that off. It's not going to hurt anything. It's, but again, we want these ribs to be perfect. So we're just going to scrape that off. Backyard guys, don't worry about it. You're not going to see it with sauce. Ain't no big deal. But we did get 3 racks of ribs on the Stampede.
Yep.
We sure baby did. Backs.
Probably could have got another 2 on there, at least another 1.
Cool. Well, I'm going to put down some brown sugar. Again, you ain't got to be super measurable about it. Just go for it. We're going to add a little bit of squeeze butter over the top. Now, a lot of people say, oh, that's disgusting, margarine. Why don't you use real butter? Because parquet won't burn.
That's right.
If you put real butter in there, it's going to burn.
Yep.
And it's not going to be good eats for you. So I'm going to add a little bit of honey. You know, one man's a little bit, one man lot, right?
That's it.
And then an extra step. And again, we learned this at Academy. I think Carlo Casanova showed us this one, a little tiger sauce on there. This is optional. Tiger sauce is a little chili sauce. You can find it right next to the condiment aisle.
It's delicious, too. I put it on everything.
You cook the heat out of it. I'm going to flip that rack over. So now I've got my meat that's going to swim in all of that delicious stuff.
All right.
But we're not done.
No.
Not done.
Not done yet, people.
So competition barbecue is all about layering flavor, and you get one bite. And ultimately, that one bite is usually a cold bite. Judges don't even eat this hot.
That's right.
That's
the reality. That's the reality of turning in boxes. You know, all these boxes get turned into all these different tables. Like, and it takes them a minute. They discuss, you know, like each bite, look at the box, talk about the box.
It's
like,
the game you play.
It's a process, right. So knowing that, you have to do stuff to take precautions to eat cold meat.
Yep. A little more tiger sauce over the top. And then I'm going to take a little bit more of that sweet rub, that Cimarron Docks.
That stuff is delicious, you
guys.
On
the back side of that rib. Cool. And then I've got 2 layers of foil here, and we'll go back to being a mime. Again, wrap it up once nice and tight. And make sure you get it tight, but not tight enough that you poke through your foil. And spend the extra $4 at the grocery store. Buy the extra heavy duty.
For sure.
And make sure you get it nice and snug. And then that second layer, same exact process.
And I would suggest you buy a big tub of heavy-duty aluminum foil. You can find it at, you know, those big surplus
stores. You got to wrap your briskets, all sorts of stuff.
That's right. And your grills.
Perfect. So this will go back on the grill.
Looks great.
Now, we're going to let these go for right about, I'm going to say, an hour. An hour, I'm going to check them. Again, internal temp I'm looking for there is going to be right about 205 to 208 degrees.
Nice.
People are like, wow, that's high. Yeah. It is, but it isn't. Okay, so we'll check them in an hour. They probably won't be at that temp.
Right.
But probably an hour and a half. So I know a lot of people are like, 3, 2, 1.
Mm-hmm.
We're not doing the 3, 2, 1.
No,
the first step is all about color, right? Yeah. Once it's beautiful mahogany, I'm good to go. That could be at the 2 hour mark, the 2.5 hour mark. Again, I really don't care.
That's right.
Right?
That's right.
Then when we wrap it up, we're going to put that butter, brown sugar, honey, tiger sauce, a little bit of that sweet rub over the top. Now is what I'm going to worry about temp.
That's right.
I want that internal temp of that pork right between the bones to be about 205 to 208 degrees. That could be anywhere from 60 minutes to, you know, maybe an hour and a half, hour and 3/4.
Right.
These are pretty good sized racks of ribs, so I'm thinking probably closer to that 90-minute mark. But don't worry. I got your back. I put a rack on earlier.
That's right.
So when we come back, we'll be pulling that rack off, and that should be temping just about right. And then we're going to get that glazed and set. We're going to pick some kale during the break.
Yeah.
But if you guys want to see how we wrap up, no pun intended, because we already did it, our competition ribs, I got no good dad. You got a good dad joke?
I don't have any good dad jokes, you know?
Jody, come on.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. You can still have good dad jokes.
Hey,
Jody, if you're out there watching, make sure you put a dad joke in there for us.
Please.
We wish the Shed and Recteq Grills a awesome time up there.
That's right. Nothing but success.
The Kingsford Tour of Champions was yesterday. That's at the World Championship Barbecue Cooking Contest in Memphis, Tennessee. Recteq has a huge tent there. I think their booth is H210.
That's it.
So if you're at Memphis in May, check those guys out. Ray Carnes is in the house. Ron Cundy's in the house. Jody, Matt, intern extraordinaire Colton Carnes, he actually graduated from high school yesterday.
He did. I think Jody's got his kid up there too.
Actually, John Dillon and Becky are up there too.
That's right.
So make sure you guys give Colton Carnes a super shout out for graduating high school. He's going to go on to do amazing things.
Yeah, yes.
We'll be live again at, 1:30?
That sounds right.
12:30.
We'll
be back at 12:30. We'll show you guys how we wrap this up. We'll see you at the Recteq.
Check it out.
We're going a little bit warmer on these, 275. The grill is reading 275. Unwrapped the whole time. Three racks. You could probably fit five on there, no problem. That's going to be dinner.
Dinner.
You guys have a good weekend. It's going to be awesome. Make sure you guys follow us. It's kind of close to our country club. Make sure you guys subscribe. And maybe jump over to the owner's page. You'll see us pick some kale. Who knows? We can't do Twitter because Jordan's not here, so we got to do something fun. You need gloves on, too? Do-do-do. You sing it?
Recteq lifestyle.
And forget it. The something's going down. Live life the way you like. Recteq lifestyle. Do-do. Sing it, country club.
Do-do-do.
Do-do-do. Recteq lifestyle. Boom.
What is up, everybody?
Sun's coming back out.
It's coming back out.
Like the one cloud in the sky went over. It must have been the biggest darn cloud because it got a little dark out here.
It did. And now the sun's back out though. Blazing.
We are. Isabel's getting her gloves on. Look at this kid. She graduated kindergarten today. Look how cute she is. Graduated kindergarten today. And now you get to cook barbecue with me and John, right?
Yeah. So awesome. Yes.
What's your favorite kind of ribs? You a baby back rib or a St. Louis rib?
A daddy rib.
A daddy rib.
A daddy rib. So, all right.
How you make daddy ribs? I'm a mustard and a Rossarooski's. Right. They love baby backs.
Okay.
And I tend to overcook them a little bit so they come right off the bone. That's how they like them.
Okay, daddy ribs.
But we're going to talk about some glazes right now. Okay. Because, again, one of my favorite barbecue sauces are gourmet sauce.
Right.
It's got a little bit of vinegar. It's got a little bit of mustard. It's got a little bit of twang to it. When you talk about like a real good all-purpose, all-in-one barbecue sauce, it's that one.
Yeah.
And if you like a little spicier, we got a hot.
That's true.
So we got you covered.
We got you covered.
But competition glazes are kind of unique.
Yes.
Lots of sugar.
Yep.
The sheen to them is amazing. That Cairo syrup. And they're, in my opinion, a little on the sweet side.
That's right.
So if you guys are looking for some two really good glazes, Yes to Your Barbecue out of Savannah, Georgia, they make really good glazes. They actually won the Reserve Grand Championship last week.
Nice.
At Boss Hog in Waynesboro.
That's what I'm talking about.
And then our boy, Matt Barber.
Love that guy.
Dude, he's awesome. With Hot Wachulas.
Yeah, love Hot
Wachulas. So not only did he win the chicken wings.
That's right.
He came, I think it was in ninth place in chicken. This peach barbecue sauce
is the real
deal. Amazing.
It's the real deal. It's legit.
If you want to like bring your wing game up.
Yep.
Matt Barber. Hot Wachulas, this is their peach sauce.
It's
really
righteous.
Tasty.
It is righteous.
But for us today, the glaze I'm going with for Banjo BBQ is going to be two parts.
All right.
So we've got the Blues Hog Competition, and I've got a little bit of Yes Dear Red. I like the tanginess, the vinegariness of that Yes Dear Red.
Yeah.
Super sweet. But again, if you look at how nice and thick and like shiny that is, like that is going to give you a glaze like none other.
Why do you think the sweeter ribs do better in competition?
I think it's a profile that the judges are definitely looking for. They like sweet, first of all. And again, a lot of times, you know, if you get something really spicy, it's going to kind of, you get one bite to make an impact.
Right.
So you want a little bit of heat, a little bit of sweet, and some acid in there so that when that meat hits your tongue,
right,
you start to salivate and you're going to be hungry. Again, you get one bite. And honestly, that bite, it's probably cold.
Yeah.
So let's go over to the bowl, let's check out our ribs, and we'll show you guys what we got going on. Again, we're cooking at 250 degrees. We are burning the Ultimate Blend pellet. We seasoned these ribs with the Cimarron Docks Sweet Rub and the Smokin' Gun Hot. You can pick up all of these rubs and glazes at atlantabbqstore.com. When you go to check out, recteq 10, 10% off. Who doesn't like a discount?
Love a discount.
I like to save money. You like to save money?
Yeah.
She likes to spend money. All right, guys, so we put this rack on probably about an hour ago. We got this one wrapped during segment two, and this one we temped a little bit ago. And you can see in the foil it's getting a little bit loose. I'm going to slide these down to put our foil pan in. It smells good.
Yeah, it does.
And again, you want to take these St. Louis ribs to an internal of about 205 to 208 degrees. So we're going to unwrap these. John, when I lift these up, you want to slide that foil pan over?
I surely will.
So again, when you're temping the ribs, You want to, now I'm not going to poke in between these because that's where I'm going to go for the box. So these outer ribs, I want to take to, you know, right about 200. We're a little 197. They're probing pretty good. And this is a slightly thinner rack. So to give me better odds when I'm slicing it, I'm going to, so I'm going to put these here like that, and we will trade these out. What's up, Pumpkin? It's on the meat and juicy. All right, so we're going to take a little bit of our glaze.
You're done with this.
You got to paint it. Yeah, buddy. I love having Chef John up here. He knows what I need when I need it.
Years of practice.
My
years
dude
of practice.
Right there. So again, we're going to brush this on.
It's looking great.
It's got to look good, man.
And that shine, you're really right. It's shimmering.
And it's all about flavor. I'm going to put a little bit more rub over the top, or the bottom, rather. And this way, that rub is going to be the first thing that's going to hit the judge's tongue.
So you really have to believe in the rubs and spices that you use, especially when you're going to coat it like that.
Absolutely. And if you don't get it, pullback is not necessarily something that's needed. But again, I'm going to take these little black spots off. And that's just going to be some blood vessels that had kind of burst in there. And if you get a cracked bone, sometimes you get some marrow coming across. But again, these got to be perfect. And normally for competition, I'll be cooking 4 racks of ribs. That way I know I'm going to get enough to sample and enough really good, really good ribs. Looking dynamite.
It does look great.
Now I'm going to go ahead and glaze these. And again, this is that combination of that Blues Hog blue and Yes Deer red. Look at that sheen.
It looks great. So how many times did you play around with the sauce before you came up with the ratio that you're using here?
I think Jody and I both had burns on our tongues with as many combinations as we tried. And for us, this is what we feel is a good compromise between what the judges are looking for and, you know, what kind of suits our taste buds. Because again, everybody that is kind of in that same sort of family,
right,
as far as flavor,
mm-hmm,
you want to be kind of within that, but a little bit better and a little bit different.
Okay.
So there we have it. I'm going to take just a little bit more of that rub over the top. Got to love those shakers. And this is going to go back on the grill. It seems like a lot of steps. And competition barbecue is a lot of steps.
Yeah.
But you know what's not a lot of steps?
What's that?
John's super easy recipe for ribs.
Yeah, that's it.
So we got 3 baby backs on the Stampede. It. We're at 275 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to let those go for about 5.5 hours. We're not touching them. Just leaving them alone.
They're going to be delicious.
It's going to be amazing.
They're going to be delicious.
Again, we're burning the ultimate pellet on that grill. That's all we cook, okay? So again, guys, we've got, look at these ribs.
So delicious.
So good. All right, we're getting this on the smoker. Come on, check it out. Plenty of room in the bowl. Look at that. And again, why I put it on the rack is I don't want to make a mess of the grill. And as this sauce kind of glazes off, it keeps it good and clean. So when I'm doing competition barbecue, typically I cook everything in pans. Check it out. There we go. And if they start to get dry, you can grab some squeeze butter and spray them.
That's what I'm talking about.
Got to. So again, these are going to tack up and not too long. We've got more celebration to do. We got more barbecue to celebrate.
Yeah, we do.
I'm excited. Jody called me a little bit ago.
All right.
They're going to hear how they did yesterday. They did the Kingsford Tour of Champions. They did, dude, a porchetta.
Yeah.
So that's a whole hog stuffed with boudin.
Yeah.
And if you guys don't know what boudin is,
I know
you're missing out.
You really are. And we've done videos with boudin.
We've done
boudin. Check them out.
Dude, that's that sausage from Louisiana.
Yep.
It's got rice and all that delicious stuff in there. They put boudin in a pig.
That's what I'm talking
about. How do you not win?
That's gangster.
Not even better than that. They put it on the BFG. So if you guys want to check that out, make sure you follow recteq Grills in the Shed at Memphis in May.
That's right.
If you're anywhere near Memphis, the World Championship Barbecue Cooking Contest, check them out. They are reigning world grand champions.
That's right.
They got there getting the pigs dressed today. They're getting cooked overnight. But they should find out how they placed in a turkey, the Tour of Champions, and I think it was Sauce yesterday.
Yeah, yeah.
Their sauce is pretty bomb, too.
Yep, sure
so
is.
We'll be back live here probably a little around 1 o'clock, maybe 1:15. But we will see you guys at the recteq. These ribs are almost done, man. I'm getting hungry.
Me, too. I'm starving.
There we go. We got to win that. We got to win that banjo.
That's it. Do-do-do. Diddle-doo-doo. Do-do-do. Do-do-do. Recteq lifestyle.
Set it and forget it.
Do-do-do.
Recteq natty style.
Yeah, I like it.
Cold beer and strawberry lemonade.
Ugh.
Dude, it's not ugh.
It is. I tasted it yesterday and it was not all that great.
Jimmy Fallon would not go ugh.
Jimmy Fallon wouldn't be drinking that though.
Jimmy Fallon would absolutely drink some Natterday.
You think so?
If he was, okay, Jimmy Fallon, I know you're out there watching. I know
you
you're
watching,
a huge recteq
Jimmy.
Family member.
Yeah.
Come on down to Augusta, Georgia. Come cook with me. That's a challenge.
There you go. Challenge
That's
it
a
up.
Challenge.
Challenge it up.
You know what else is a challenge? These ribs.
That's what I'm
There's
going
to be
about.
No challenge for these ribs next week.
Show them, Chef Greg.
Come on, buddy.
Show them, Chef Greg.
I feel like I'm a broken record. We're set for 250. We're running 250. That Y-Pellet Wi-Fi controller has your back all day long. I put these ribs on this morning. I went to my daughter's kindergarten graduation. The grill didn't move. Look at how nice and shiny and amazing those ribs are. And again, I don't recommend taking pans and things out of the grill. Get you some competition gloves right here. Be a meme, okay?
There you go.
Get you some.
That's
All right, so we have our ribs.
Delicious.
What we're gonna do is, first we gotta get a drink.
Yeah, get your drink, Chef.
Cheers, buddy, it's been fun.
Oh, no, I thought you were handing me your disgusting beer.
It's
my bad.
It's terrible.
No, it has been fun. You have a lovely setup for this kind of thing.
Dude, it's 2 days in a row I get to cook with you. I'm a happy guy.
Me too.
So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to paint my board.
You're painting the board? Why are you painting the board, Chef?
Because I don't want my glaze to fall off.
Oh.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of just give it a schmear. And this is why you want those recteq Nitrile gloves, right here.
That's it.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip these ribs over.
In the schmear.
And now I'm in the schmear.
There you go.
And I can look. I can see my bones are kind of running on a slight angle, okay? And right when it gets about here, they start to straighten up.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get right in the middle here.
So what are you looking for, the straightest bone?
I'm looking for not the bone.
Okay.
Okay? And what we'll do is we will cut right in between. And these are a little thinner than I would normally want to do, but hey, these are not the ribs we're gonna use for Banjo BBQ. Just the process. And again, I'll come back over here and I'll slice these.
So the bones that were kind of at an angle, we could still box with those, or are you looking for
we
the
are.
Straightest
yep.
bones?
Normally okay. I would probably cook about 4 racks of ribs.
Okay.
And then we're only going to use probably those 4 in there.
Would you use the same racks or same ribs from the same rack, or do you mix and match on the rack, Chef?
I don't mind mixing and matching.
Okay.
And I think the easiest thing to do is just grab kind of your hands. And you can use brushes and stuff, but we just want to paint that rib right here. Look at that.
It's delicious.
It's going to play.
I wish y'all could smell this stuff. It's so good.
And these are going to be bite-through ribs. Look at how good that looks.
So good.
Look at that rib.
If you guys know anybody who loves ribs, please make sure you like and share.
Got to.
So they can keep up to date with all the stuff that's happening with ribs these days.
I'm excited to see how the guys did up at Memphis in May.
Me
Jody
too.
Jody and the guys up there.
It's a huge event. I don't know if everybody is familiar with the event, but it is a huge event, and we killed it last year.
They didn't kill it. They won the World Grand Championship of barbecue.
That's what I'm talking about.
Not just the Grand Championship, the World Grand Championship.
That's big time.
Huge.
That's big time.
Huge. All right, guys, we're getting there. So what we're going to do is we're going to build this box. And normally you want to slide that that one away, and we'll redo this.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go 8 bones in that box.
You want to talk about your box real quick?
Well, you decorated that box amazingly, John.
Well,
with some kale.
Yeah, we just got some kale. We made sure it was clean. We took pretty much the tips and the nicest looking pieces of the kale and kind of just formed this box making sure that the best parts of the kale were facing up. Chef Greg went ahead and lined the outside of one of the boxes to make sure that none of the sauce is going to touch any of the edges, because the cleaner your box, the better for presentation, the more points you're going to get.
You can't have a dirty box.
Right.
It's got to be clean. Oh, you don't want a glove on there either. That's bad. But see, I got a little messy here. Not a problem, because I got the paper there. So I can take a little bit more of my glaze, and again, you can redo if you need to.
What about the top of the box too, Chef, right?
You don't want to make a mess of that either. So then there's the box. And then Jody's got the hardest job. And again, if you want to, you can get back in here and you can reposition if you got to smush down. And again, Jody has the hardest time because he's got to take that box. He's got to take this winning box.
That's right.
To the judges.
Get it to the judges.
But you know what else we got to talk about?
What's
somebody
that?
Else has to win today.
That's right. We got to have a winning person, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So you guys have probably seen some posts out there. I want to welcome my friend Tina in from the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society.
Killed it.
And we got a raffle.
That's right.
So tell us about what's going on tonight.
So tonight is the grand finale for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society campaign for Man and Woman of the Year. I was so graciously nominated to be the Woman of the Year. We'll find out tonight if I actually win.
Oh, congratulations.
See, you know what? When they came over, she left that part out, that she was in the running for Woman of the Year.
That's awesome.
That's fantastic.
That is.
That's right.
Well, Funday Friday just got better.
We did.
That's right.
We cooked it up a notch.
Bring it up a notch.
So recteq was gracious enough to donate a Stampede grill. We've sold 475 tickets for this grill, and we have got a lot of folks out there waiting to find out who's going to win this grill.
So we got a great way to give this away. We took all of these entries, 475 entries. We put them in the Trailblazer RT340.
That's right.
If you've ever been curious about what 475 entries looks like, Isabel's going to pick a winner out of this grill right now.
That's right.
Let me mix them up. 475 entries. No, you got to pick. I didn't buy any tickets. Come on. All right, pick a winner.
Pick a winner.
Wait, mix it around. Is that the winner? Boom, we got the winner right here. You got it. You guys want to see who's going to win?
It's Ben Dukes.
Ben Dukes.
Awesome, Ben Dukes. Yeah.
So how can he claim that prize? You going to reach out to him, give him a phone call?
I'm going to be calling you, Ben, in just a few minutes.
All right.
Awesome. I want to take my call.
That's awesome.
It. Congratulations,
well,
Ben.
Again, that's super awesome. Yeah. I wish you the best of luck tonight.
We totally
hopefully
do.
Hopefully our friend Tina can be the Woman of the Year.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
That is fantastic.
She left those details out.
That would have been really important to know.
But I think I'm ready to eat a rib.
I said we should try some.
You want to eat some ribs?
Yeah. Tina, would you like to join us and eat a rib?
Well, we eat ribs special around here. Why? Because we don't get messy hands.
No.
Because we live the recteq lifestyle.
We wear
our nitrile gloves.
That's right.
Because you want all of that flavor to stay on the rib, not your fingers.
I don't mind licking my fingers. You know, I'm old school like that. But you know.
Well, I mean, you know.
When in Rome. Yeah, when in Rome.
Got to. This is the only way Ray Carnes will eat a rib. Rib and chicken wings.
Rib and chicken wings.
But hey, guys, it's been a fantastic Funday Friday. Make sure you guys subscribe to us on YouTube. Make sure you follow Jody and the Shed Barbecue in Memphis. I'm excited to see what goes down. They find out today how they did a Tour of Champions yesterday. They're going to kill it. That whole hog porchetta was fantastic. Make sure you jump over to Instagram and follow all of our stories so you can see all of those behind-the-scenes shenanigans that are going on. I'm excited. It's been a fantastic Funday Friday.
Yeah,
John,
thank
Tina,
you.
Best
thank
of luck tonight.
Thanks,
let's eat some ribs. Do. We got to go for a bite through. Mm-hmm. Do.
That's pretty good.
Very good.
That's pretty good.
Very good.
Yeah.
The grill did all the work.
The grill did. This is delicious.
Yummy.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
It's a shame we got to eat all this and everybody's got to be watching.
I'm just telling you.
Yeah,
I wish you guys were here.
Look at this. I'll take another bite.
So good.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You want to check out those baby back ribs here? Ben Dukes, this is the grill you just won, buddy.
Ben Dukes.
You go, Ben.
So
Stampede RT 590, 590 square inches of cook space, plenty of room. Those are three ginormous racks of baby back ribs. We have a 30-pound hopper on this grill.
So good, right?
Stainless steel barrel. You can cook for over 30 hours at 300 degrees on this grill. It comes standard with that Y-pellet Wi-Fi controller, that 304 stainless steel fire pot. That ceramic hot flash ignition system. It's good for 100,000 on-off cycles. Four-year warranty on that grill. Four-year warranty. This thing, bad to the bone.
I'm telling you, you're killing it.
All right, guys, it's been a fantastic Funday Friday. Make sure you tune in on Monday on YouTube. Watch this video in its entirety. You might find you can win something yourself.
That's what I'm talking
about. It might not be an RT590, but you guys can win something good.
And make sure you tune in to Mix It Up Monday. Every Monday, we'll be tuning in 6 o'clock this Monday. We'll have a special guest bartender. We'll be mixing up drinks, cooking food. It's going to be a great time.
Gotta love you guys. We'll see you guys at the Rec Tech. Do, do, do. Do, do, do.